As the world moves out of the industrial era into the era of information and communication, the industrialized character of distance education has undergone change. The trend in neo-industrialization is product innovation and process variability. Goods are produced on demand and in time, mass-producing learning materials that are kept in stock for years and become outdated in relation to the needs of students is no longer desirable. This weakened Fordism and gave birth to Neo-Fordism that caters more to students' needs. In Neo-Fordist system, course development, delivery, and administration are mixed between centralized office and regional or local offices. Division of labor is limited. The effect of Neo-Fordism on teaching and learning are giving of allowance for more flexibility in course development and delivery. The teacher here is given little responsibility beyond delivering the developed materials.
Neo-Fordism offers shorter minor courses that meet the needs of students, and these may be easily revised since their learning materials have not been produced in large volumes.
This reshapes the roles of teachers in two ways. The positive aspects are giving behavioral-based instructional design, providing short-term courses, locally producing teaching in study centers with more face-to-face sessions, teleconferencing, and intensive personal counseling. The negative aspects of teaching roles are simply delivering curriculum prepared for them. Labor responsibility is low. Teachers do not engage in research, scholarly inquiry, and curriculum development. The direction that Neo-Fordism took led to autonomous learning, independent learning in the digital learning environment, contract learning, and the combination with and integration of forms of traditional university teaching. Students' roles are through developing themselves to become autonomous learner, independent learner, and contract learner. Neo-Fordism has high product innovation and high process variability, but maintains low labor responsibility.